A memory palace is a type of memory technique where you imagine a physical location to help you remember more abstract information. The reason that memory palaces work is that our brains are better at remembering images and locations, as opposed to abstract things like names and numbers. Let's start with an example to show you how this works. Let's say that you're trying to remember the 6 drugs or drug classes that are known to cause pancreatitis, or inflammation of the pancreas. The list goes diuretics, corticosteroids, alcohol, azathioprine, didanosine, and valproic acid. First things first, though, you have to ask yourself, is this something that's worth remembering and is the learning objective clear? Clinically, it's really helpful to have these 6 drugs or drug classes in your working memory, so that you can spot them on a medication list and think about them as a potential cause of pancreatitis. So if you decide it's worth remembering a list like this using a memory palace, you've got to start with picking a place that you're familiar with, like a bedroom. It doesn't have to be a bedroom though, it could be any place you know, like the gym, a store, or some place you've seen or imagined like in a TV show like The Office. Next, you can start identifying specific spots called loci in that place. It's nice to pick really distinct spots. And in this case, we'll pick out 6 spots because there are 6 things to remember. Let's go with the bed, the window, the doorway, the dresser, the rug, and the ceiling light. Next, you have to create images for each term you're trying to remember. To do this, you can try a few approaches. First, you might go with sounds like. For example, papule sounds a little like papa and mule. So you might imagine an excited new dad riding around on his baby mule. Another trick is to go with looks like. For example, a parietal cell looks kind of like a fried egg. Finally, you might try seems like. For example, taking sedative medication and feeling drowsy seems like what a bear might feel while hibernating through the winter. But rather than try to analyze which trick you're using, you should simply use whichever image first comes to mind. So in our pancreatitis example, you might imagine someone urinating all over the sheets to help you think of diuretics on the bed, a huge steroid-using bodybuilder smashing the window to think of corticosteroids in the window, a drunk person missing the doorway and running straight into the wall for alcohol in the doorway, maybe Aslan the lion from Narnia hiding in your dresser drawer for azathioprine, maybe a Titanic sinking into the fuzzy rug for didanosine, and finally, for valproic acid, a valiant Professor Indiana Jones swinging from the ceiling light. The more unique and descriptive the image, the better it will stick, because our minds love to hang on to interesting visual images in familiar settings. So that's how it works. The memory palace provides a scaffold for abstract information, and over time it can help your brain organize and connect concepts. And don't worry if you're not good at drawing, because you actually don't have to draw anything out. You can simply just imagine it, and it works just as well. With this technique, you learn faster while forgetting less, and creating the images themselves makes learning more enjoyable and adds a little flavor to the usual study routine. In terms of making a memory palace, it's always important to pick the right material to apply this learning tool. Typically, you want to pick something where the learning objective's really clear, like learning the steps of a process or a list. Making your own memory palace can take time, but studies suggest that it's worth the effort, because the memory palace is more personalized and therefore easier to remember. Having said that though, the difficulty of the material really matters. And for difficult information and concepts, really well-crafted memory palaces are likely to be more accurate and higher quality. So given the availability of great resources for memory palaces, the ideal situation for a student might be to make simple memory palaces themselves and use existing well-crafted ones for tough material, until they feel ready to take on those challenging topics themselves. Alright, as a quick recap of the causes of pancreatitis, take a second right now and try to think of the 6 drugs or drug classes that can lead to pancreatitis. Hey, what's happening, folks? Thanks for watching that video on memory palaces. Hopefully you learned a thing or two about learning. It was kind of a learning technique video, which we do from time to time. So hopefully you found it helpful. It was actually a pretty cool one because we collaborated with a bunch of memory sort of experts, including Alex Mullen and Kathy Chen of Mullen Memory, who know all about this Memory Palace technique, as well as Sketchy Medical, who is another company that does their own Memory Palace-based videos. So thank you to those two groups. And also kind of shout out to Rishi for editing. I did the illustration on that video, which was really fun because those images are kind of wacky and awesome to think about and draw. So that was a really fun video to make. If you want to check out Osmosis, you can head over to osmosis.org where we have a bunch of flashcards, quiz questions, and other stuff related to medical content. So if you're interested in that, check out our website, osmosis.org. You can always support us by donating on Patreon and subscribing to our channel and following us on social media. All right, everyone. See you later.